What is up? Welcome back. Appreciate game two of the day. It's UNC versus Wagner, the one seed versus the 16 seed. Hopefully we don't see a crazy upset like we did a couple years back. But if you guys joined us from the last game, we saw the Spartans take down the Bulldogs in the round one. They move on to the round two. So appreciate y'all hanging out here. Make sure you hit that like button. We had a really good stream last one, but I noticed this time the bots are big time. So hopefully NCAA does their thing like they have in the past and shut all these guys down, and we'll have some more fun in here and more people will flow in here as well. So make sure you're hitting that like button for us and subscribing to the channel. And we're going to be getting here live here in just a second. Let's listen in to the boys in the studio as they're talking about some stuff.
They're guardable. And so 3-point shooting in these 6-game run.
How many times have you read North Carolina's been a number one seed?
No.
I would say
probably 18.
18 is the number.
I was going to say 19.
Were you really?
Yeah. 18. Sure, what do we have?
Was he going to say it? Hell no.
R.J. Davis, the scorer for North Carolina.
How about that?
We certainly hope you enjoy the game here on.
How about that, sir?
So good to be back with you for the madness, y'all.
Actually, it was good.
All right, commercial break. Let's go to the main screen. Let's talk about the players and the teams. The Wagner Seahawks, they're 17-15, and they made the tournament. Unbelievable. The North Carolina Tar Heels, 27-7. Good chance of winning the whole thing. And we got a lot of Tar Heel fans here tonight. So I hope you have, make sure you're hitting that like button for us and telling everybody else about it. Share the stream out as well. We are ready to have some fun here today on the channel. So we had a great stream last stream. Let's see if we can get even more folks in here for this North Carolina game. You had potatoes and manwich. Yeah, there you go, Kenneth Clark. So about 5-6 more minutes till tip off. Go Heels, Spain says. Spain says go Heels. A lot of Tar Heel fans. Last time we had a Tar Heel game, it was against Tennessee, and it was probably one of our largest basketball streams we ever did. Almost 10,000 views on that Spartans game. Let's see here. What did our last stream just do? Let's see. Almost 6,000 views. I'll take that. 5.7. 5.7. Well, I don't know if we'll get there this time with all the bots, but what's up, John? Go Seahawks, he says. Go Seahawks. So the Canes is up 58-56 on BYU. Creighton's finally pulling away from Akron 42-34. And Long Beach State giving Arizona, oh Lord, a run. It is 33-all. 33-all on that one. So, all right. Come on, NCAA. Shut all these bots down. They're all going to keep y'all in the chat there until they turn it off. They're not doing their job like normal. All right. So the North Carolina Tar Heels versus the Wagner Seahawks coming up. Same thing, audio, play-by-play, all that good stuff is going to be coming to you live. We had a good stream last time. It was fun. Let's see here. For the Wagner Seahawks, like Council Jr., 14.6 points per game. Council is also their top rebounder at 5.7 points per game. And what's the other guy's name? Let's see. Esquada. All right, we go. We're ready.
Northeast Conference. Tuesday at the First Four in Dayton. Wagner notching their first NCAA tournament win. Melvin Council Jr. went for 21 points. A big lead got away. Howard had not one, not two, but three good looks to tie the game. Wagner survived, and now they are here. Charlotte, North Carolina, in UNC's backyard, trying to play bracket buster. We're in the West region. Winner plays Michigan State on Saturday. Hi, everybody. I'm Brian Anderson, along with Jim Jackson, the College Basketball Hall of Famer. Looking forward to this matchup here, Jimmy, because North Carolina grabbed the last number one seed in March Madness. This is a team with so much experience to call on, and one of the great players in this tournament, in R.J. Davis.
Yeah, R.J. Davis dropped a smooth 43-pointer against Miami back in February. But this young man, first team AP All-American, first one for North Carolina since Justin Jackson, I think, back in 2016. But this game has evolved so much. I mean, in regards to not just shooting the basketball, but putting it on the deck and scoring inside. And then you always need a big fella inside you can depend on. Armando Bacot, look at the games played, the points behind our guy Tyler Hansbrough, who's down doing radio right now. Just a really good inside-outside combination of veteran leadership.
Will this be the year? Bacot in his fifth year, all that experience for the Tar Heels. How about Melvin Council Jr. coming up big when it counted the most Tuesday?
I'm going to tell you what. Listen, this young man can play at 6'4". He loves to get 2 feet in the paint, has a little reverse spin.
I'm sure you're
in
reporting
there.
Those bots,
not afraid,
y'all,
to take the big shot. You talked about what he was able to do inside.
Out of the NEC, Wagner against UNC from the ACC next.
Wagner from the UNC for the ACC. Wagner's in the ACC now. All right, just waiting on the game to start here. Make sure you're hitting that like button for us. North Carolina Tar Heels should be an easy one for them. But I want to do a UNC game, and we'll probably do UNC and Tennessee in the tournament. That's... got a lot of friends that are UNC fans, so maybe they'll come in here today. I know it's the middle of the day, but as you're coming in, hit that like button for us. We're trying to get to 100 likes. We came so close last game. on the stream, 100 likes. So maybe some folks will come in here and find us tonight. But we'll have live audio for the game, our reactions, the live stats for both teams. You'll see who's got what. We have a running ticker as well right here. So you can see the games that are on and what finals there are. So we have a running ticker for you guys. Man, BYU and them tied at 60. Holy smokes. Man, that's going to be a good one. Down to the wire. It says 60 to 58, but it's more than that. Y'all might as well just stay here because they're going to shut those streams down if you're looking for it live. They'll be shutting it down here pretty soon. Well, that's your purpose code. Report this game. All right, who you guys got in this chat? I'm going UNC. What's the over under? The over under is 133, and the line is 25 and a half. Oh, I'm going on the under on this. There's no way. There could be. They could have blown them out by 25. We'll see. I don't think so, though. I'm going under on the line, and I'm going I'm going to go under on the over-under, 133 and a half. That's what I'm going. That's what I'm going. All right.
TNT, connecting changes
everything. Let's go. Everything. Have some fun, y'all.
And by Geico. Whatever you need, get more with Geico.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to Charlotte, where game two of our four-game day tips off in just moments from now. UNC versus Wagner. And Wagner's team motto this entire season has been simple. It's toughness. Led by Coach Donald Copeland, he knows
Matthew,
that it's going to take every
under
game
and under.
Toughness to
me
win
too.
This game against UNC, but he has led
What's
team
up,
Hall
Dragon Dabs?
Two NCAA so? Tournament appearances in 2004 and 2006, so he knows what it takes, and he told me yesterday, quote, I am on them so hard. The most difficult thing they will ever have to go through is me. And I'll tell you guys, we witnessed it yesterday, even after traveling from Dayton, where they played in the first four, to Charlotte, arriving at 3 in the morning. The team was running sprints during its open practice yesterday. They will be in shape, but will they have the skill, the stamina, and a little bit of luck to get this win today?
That's a great call, Allie. And only 7 players well chronicled at the first four. They are very thin, but they have arrived with an NCAA tournament victory under their belt. You see the starting five, Javier Esquerra, Julian Brown, Melvin Council, Teron Allen, and Keontae Lewis. Familiar starting five for the Heels with Elliot Cadeau, RJ Davis, Cormac Ryan, Harrison Ingram, and Armando Bacon. North Carolina.
All right, North Carolina on white,
number one
blue
seed, the regular
stripes,
season champions
all
in
black
the ACC.
For Wagner.
Made it as high
Tip
as
off.
Three in the points.
UNC wins it, of course.
They kick it off here
North Carolina on their
Carolina
chest.
As they win the tip, it'll feel like a home game for the Tar Heels. The winner of this one advancing to the second round in a matchup with Michigan State. Harrison Ingram gets the first touch down low. And the first basket of the ball game turned in by Harrison Ingram.
Yeah. Harrison Ingram with the basket.
You slow the tempo down. Can you keep North Carolina out of the paint? You only have 7 players, so you're limited to how aggressive you can be defensively because you don't want to get in the
foul
trouble.
Wagner with the ball.
Does that change how Wagner has to play? We saw early on. NC go right to the paint.
Keontae Lewis backing down Baycott. That'll be a matchup to watch today.
This
Lewis
is their first shot, Wagner. Wagner. Here comes UNC.
Seahawks from Staten Island, New York, with an enrollment just over 2,000. Heath Howard in the first four on Tuesday in Dayton. That was a 3-point victory. Baycott gets it inside. No trouble scoring.
It'll
be much shorter. Julian Brown.
Easy. 2 points.
Cormac Ryan coming off that screen. extremely fast and hard, attracted two defenders. The roll man was Baycott, had the advantage inside, able to score another paint point.
Don't have to
Wagner here on the ball, bottom baseline. Shoot two. And misses.
A few years ago, but Charlotte was the location in this arena where UMBC made history and took down Virginia as the first back ever out. 16 seed to be the one
seed. Spin move to the basket. Good.
Another bucket down, and that is R.J. Davis.
R.J. Davis.
First team All-American, consensus All-American when it's all said and done.
6-0. Since Justin Tar Heels.
As an AP first team All-American. Continues to stack a wonderful career. He's a New York native from White Plains, New York, taking on a team from Staten Island. That one's short from Taren Allen. Tar Heels one.
Mission Braves. Nice.
Talented freshman point guard.
6-0 still. Tar Heels.
Ryan gives it up and now gets it back.
Tar Heels to the basket.
Missed it.
And misses.
Deontay Lewis with the rebound.
UNC might win by 50. We'll see. Wagner up and in. Misses that one.
First attempt. Ingram out of the pack. Carolina wants to run. David from the floor. Look at Iskara with the steal up ahead.
Oh, a steal. Wagner. And in. They score.
Well, that's the defense that we talked about in regards to why Wagner is so potent. The ability to get back that time. And that's a way, too, to kind of exit your offensive sets.
What's up, Dallas?
To try to get some easier baskets if you can create that off turnover. There he is again.
Turnover.
By
here comes Wagner.
Puerto Rico, he's on his way. Leaves it on the wing. Three-pointer, no good.
Oh, he missed it.
Had a good look at it at Julian Brown. Escara right there
Wagner
again.
Wagner with the turnover.
Escara
gets the ball back.
Yeah, and they got to look at resetting the shot clock off of the offensive.
Keep hitting that like button.
Escara, you got to know when to push, when to pull back.
They work on the clock. It'll be Wagner ball. Melvin Council Jr., Julian Brown, Javier Escara played all 40 minutes. Again, there's only seven available players for Donald Copeland. Allie mentioned he was a terrific guard at Seton Hall, twice in the NCAA tournament as a player, another occasion as an assistant under Kevin Willard at Seton Hall. Now his first chance as the head man at Wagner. That's a foul. Council will go to the line. He's got two coming. Council aggressive driving to the basket.
What the difference, you saw those minutes, right? 40-40-40. In the NEC, you probably can get away with that. Against this North Carolina team, because they're a little bit more physical, they're bigger, they're going to wear into you a little bit more. So it'll be very important how Donald Copeland kind of sneaks some minutes in abreast of his main guys.
Knocks the first free throw down. Don't forget, get complete coverage of the NCAA Division I Women's Tournament on NCAA.com.
It's Wagner.
Another free throw coming here. R.J. Davis.
6-3.
A little blood to manage here.
So we get the 20 likes. Help us get there.
UNC athletic trainer Doug Halverson. Now North Carolina.
Wow, BU
lost
well,
to NC State. That amazing run by the Wolfpack in the ACC tournament, winning five games in 5 days. Carolina had won eight
Forget
straight
Frosty's
games
yet.
Before they lost that ACC title game. Beat Duke twice, Jimmy. Lost to Kentucky and UConn. They belong in this very top-heavy grouping of number one seeds. They do get the Charlotte draw for their opening round. But if they're going to go to the Sweet 16, it's going to have to go out west.
And a missed free throw. Here comes UNC.
Not an easy path. You see the parity kind of in college basketball. And not to panic at a lot of high seeds, number one seeds, beautiful pick and roll again with the empty corner, lost in their conference tournaments. And some would say that could be a good thing in regards to getting rest. But at the end of the day, you want to win.
They saw the Preds score
game,
7 goals, so they had to score 7 goals.
In your mind, it's all for naught if you don't. But I'm going to tell you something. DJ Burns Jr. for North Carolina
State. Hit that subscribe button as well,
put
y'all.
On a clinic.
Stud.
I mean, big boy.
Yeah, cannot inside. Wait to watch him play.
I'm going to tell you something, man. It was his ability to pass the bust basketball out of double teams.
Yes.
Armando Baycott, they went one-on-one. They tried to double him, but he was doing everything that you can imagine a post player could do inside, and he did it with a high IQ.
Well, Davis, certainly good. Affected. Where's that Baycott?
Some of the draws for the NCAA Baycott Tournament Selection Committee. NC State was certainly not a team that was going to March Madness until they won the ACC tournament.
What do you think about this? What, NC State, a team like UAB or Temple, you know, bid Steelers, and then you figure that the Big East only got three teams in.
Wagner goes for the three. And he nails it.
Big hit for Brown. Had 15 against Howard on Tuesday. Made three threes in
Brown
that game.
With a three.
Get it going from beyond the arc. Baycott goes right.
Baycott making it look easy to the basket. It's 10-6.
And a mismatch inside Baycott with all of his experience, all of his pedigree. Baycott did have 18 against NC State in that ACC tournament final and 12 rebounds. Again, Brown passed up a three. Davis right on him. Slips the pass.
Wow, Wagner Lewis making this a game. 10-8.
How about this? How about that Wagner kind of absorbed the early
spoke too soon, John.
North Carolina kind of figured it out and offensively been a lot more efficient.
I'm sure they'll eventually wear down. Baycock just manhandling and good.
As fundamental as you can get. Tell you, the longer seeds like this, 16s, 15s, 14s, the longer they hang around,
they got with
the more
eight
the screws tighten. Donald Copeland knows better than anybody.
They've eight of the last 12. BYU lost. Crazy. Here comes UNC intercepted by Wagner.
Third already. And Escara had that slap out of his hand by Ryan. It'll be
four
Wagner
turnovers by UNC back already, Rondo playing Baycott sloppy.
Best, Jimmy. Well, another point inside, you're talking about basic
I really think that was an upset,
no
though.
Like, the glass
a lot of people picked them ball to lose. Halftime, commercial first TV timeout. Make sure you're hitting that like button and subscribing. This is our second game of the day. First game we did, Mississippi State versus Michigan State. The Spartans come up victory over there, knocking out the SEC. So they move on to the second round. So today we're bringing you live coverage with the audio from the CBS broadcast of the UNC Tar Heels versus the Wagner Seahawks. We're making live audio, our reactions, play-by-play, all that good stuff. Make sure you're hitting that like button and subscribing to the channel for more NCAA basketball. Our goal is to get to 10,350. 10,350 for this game. Let's see if we can get to 400 by the end of the night. But looks like BYU's going down. They're losing by three. And then Akron is losing to Creighton 56-42. Arizona kind of pulling away from Long Beach State 41-35. And that is it. Bracket doing real good right now. 0-2, Matthew says. Oh, man, that sucks. But appreciate y'all hanging out with us. See if we can get some more folks in here as the bots get shut down. But we do have a live ticker here for you guys, so you can see the games as they are going in the finals. So that is that. We have redeems. If you are a Tar Heel fan, we have a redeem for you. Redeem Tar Heel. There's that one. And if you are a Wagner fan, if there's any Wagner fans in here, please speak up, because I would love to see if a Wagner fan is watching my stream. It is Redeem Wagner. So that is that. I saw that, Craig. See if they show up here. Let's see if they show up. Do, 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 do. There's the Seahawks. Did the UNC one not come up? Did the UNC one not come up? Tar Heel. Oh, I guess it never. Maybe it's Tar Heels. I think it's Tar Heels. Yeah, it was Tar Heels. I have to have an S at the end there. If you're just coming in, my name is CeeLo. We're doing college basketball, NCAA college basketball for you guys. We have redeems in the chat for you guys. And if you're a member, we have Tar Heel redeems as well. And let's see if it's in there now. Yeah, so here we go. Tar Heel, North Carolina. We have that one. And we also have a Wagner redeem
today
for you Wagner fans, if there is any.
Davis, glad to be here in his third year as the head man at UNC, ACC Coach of the Year. First time for Davis as head coach winning the ACC regular season title. A quiet
I hear Wagner
day,
ball.
Jimmy,
8-12.
Coach, and he's got a great team to work
Whoa,
with.
Whoa, 12-10.
Out of the timeout, Keontae Lewis.
Lewis with a 2 points.
Two-point game.
Beautiful play coming out of the timeout to be able to.
Tar Heels to the basket.
Lewis inside.
Back out.
Inside Withers, the Charlotte native, takes the contact.
Withers gets fouled.
Jalen Withers, his first minute on the floor. He's going to the free throw line.
Well, execution.
What's up, Lenny? What's going on, buddy?
Underneath, out of bounds. A down screen, post up right in the middle, jump hook. This team operates efficiently because they take care of the basketball, they make solid passes, and they pay attention to little details. And that one right there is what you want coming out the timeout.
First one misses from Withers.
Man,
count
hit your free
your
throws.
Side, Jimmy. You can refresh your fandom with a delicious Coke Zero Sugar. Is it the best Coke ever? You can try and decide.
You know, best thing about the couch? You can have that and a cigar with it, Brad. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Give me cigar bar is always open.
It's always open.
Jalen Withers, one out of two at the line. Started his career in Louisville. And now back in his hometown of Charlotte.
13-10.
From the Tar Heels of Carolina. Got a few transfers.
Wagner Ball.
Davis has not been afraid of the portal. Mascara, guarded by Ryan, gives it back. Council.
Now back out.
Probing once again.
Wagner looking.
Brown.
He'll shoots a three.
Try. Not afraid. Got some range.
Oh, he nailed it.
Julian Brown. He hit the
Brown with
free
the three.
Throws late in the first four game Tuesday against
and
Howard.
It's all tied up,
ties
folks.
It up at 13 with a second made three-pointer.
I tell you what, this Wagner team, from an execution perspective on the last four possessions.
Are you worried, Jake?
Has just been
and he just threw it away. A turnover.
Baycott throws it away. It'll be Wagner Ball and a chance to take the lead. Already four turnovers.
Yeah, now Julian Brown ended up with the shot, but it was the ball movement, the spacing, and then the confidence for Brown. You talked about it coming off 15 points against Howard. He has 62 made threes. That's third in the NEC in their conference. So not afraid to put them up.
Brown again. Now it's
they haven't played in a while. Wagner spin move up to the basket and misses.
Well,
rebound, Carolina.
The heel set Trimble gives it to Withers. Washington,
yeah, 25 ain't happening. That's why I
got
said
stuck though, and he's fouled. So Withers has been active.
So Withers gets fouled again.
Foul starting to stack up a little bit. Zongo picks up the foul. Keontae Lewis with two early ones. And you figure the big men of Wagner, that's going to be a major story. Just trying
we'll see,
to stay
Kenneth.
Foul
we'll trouble see.
With all the size and
Withers hits that one this time heels. Finally.
There's Roy Williams. Man's got a sweater collection, doesn't he? Big
a
league.
A sweater.
Yep.
Roy
sweater
Williams.
Collection.
In the house.
Best since Ted Knight, I think.
Got it. But you see early, North Carolina points in the paint. 10 out of 13. 0 3-pointer shot attempted. So game plan, dominate the paint. Body blow, body blow, body blow. Then once you make the defense kind of succumb 15-13 to that.
Here.
That's when those open shots or those drives will be there. So we're going to keep our eye on that and see if
and
that
get
kind
a three
of plays
here. Wagner
to their hands.
Look at
Coach Williams. Looks pretty calm right now. It's Brown.
He shoots it up. Tied it up.
Baseline jumper. All tied at 15.
Wow.
Armando Baycott said.
Didn't
Coach
expect
Roy
this.
Williams was on his case his freshman year. He didn't even think he liked him. Now he's,
he
he's
needs
like
those
a
upsets.
He's one of his best friends.
If he didn't like
Brown
him,
with 8 points.
So that's
three.
Better him be
drains
loud.
It.
Loud. That was a loud three.
UNC.
That time by RJ
Davis. RJ
Davis
with the
one.
Big three. Puts
it
up 18-15.
You know, a team, higher seed team, hanging around and getting confidence. Wagner has done that. Kind of put themselves right back in this one position game.
Tajay Kelly
back
on
out.
The floor now for Wagner. Top corner, Iskara trying to find some space, had a big man on him.
Wagner wide open in the basket, tried to use the backboard, did not work.
Cormac Ryan.
Here comes UNC.
40-plus percent three-point shooter.
Almost a turnover there. Gets it back. Davis throws it up.
And the finger roll from
Withers with the layup.
Was some athleticism there. Pass wasn't great from Davis, but a good recovery.
Well, sometimes we got hops like that. just throw it anywhere close to the top of the backboard. You know about that.
What's right? that like, Jim?
You know about that, right?
Tell us all.
What I'm saying, you know about throwing the pass, not catching the pass, yes.
Zongo.
You even know on that problem.
Back to Esquera.
Sexongo.
Three. Oh, in and out for Wagner.
Zongo, he's going to find himself Zongo. Open for some opportunities.
Zongo. You know, coach has always said, you know you're open for a reason, right? We're one for nine.
Weathers again.
From behind
Weathers,
three.
Weathers gets fouled again.
Free throws coming. Jalen Weathers has been active coming off the bench in his hometown. Davis put it up top. Nice recovery in the air, and Weathers scores it. Carolina by five.
I'm telling you, Coach
right.
Staley.
I could. There we go. Appreciate y'all hanging out with us. See if we can get some more folks in here. Hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for the new subscribers. We're at 10,344 now. Moving on up. Moving on up. See if we can get some more folks in here as the bots get shut down slowly. After this, I think there's a little break in between the games here in Charlotte. And then we'll be back tonight for the Texas Colorado State game, and then right after that will be Tennessee versus the St. Peter's Peacocks. So two more games on the slate for us today, and I'm glad for y'all to join us here. So I've always wanted to stream the March Madness days, and that's what we're doing. We're at 22 likes. Let's see if we can get to 40. That'll be our new goal, 40 likes. So appreciate the subscribe. Thank you so much for that. Let's wait on here to see. Over on the Wagner side, Lewis, he's got 4 points. Council's got 3. And 8 for Brown. On the other side, you got... I need to move this down a little bit. There we go. On the other side, Baycock's got 8. And Davis has got 5. Shooting percentage, UNC's 87% from the field, 40% for Wagner. And UNC is 100% on the 3-point shot with that one from RJ Davis. That's always good to see that here. You got one team wrong in your bracket already, BYU. Morton went 5 innings, gave up 3 walks and a strikeout and 2 runs. All right, that isn't too bad. Oh, Uncle Charlie. So commercial coming back here in about 30 seconds as Akron and Creighton in the third, second half. Creighton up 65-47, pulling away from Akron. And Arizona and Long Beach State at the half. We'll be bringing back the live audio for you guys. Make sure you're sharing the stream out on your social medias. And shut the bots down when you see them. Give them a little report. Here we go.
Wagner hanging tough in the early going here. Round one matchup. North Carolina leads it by 5. Julian Brown, 8 points. He's knocked down 2 threes. Armando Bacon out of the
game. What's up, CJ?
8 points for the Tar Heels. Moment ago, Allie LaForce with head coach Hubert Davis.
What did you choose to focus on in the last timeout?
Well, we got to take care of the basketball. You know, I mean, we're doing a great job defensively, and then we've had 3 unforced turnovers, and so that just can't happen. We did a good job rebounding, getting the ball. Let's take care of on the offensive end, and let's get shots.
Thank you, Coach.
Yeah, thank you.
And our thanks to Hubert Davis.
Another free throw.
In year 3, Withers knocks down the free throw. A guy you know very well, Hubert Davis. He almost like he was born to take over this job from Roy Williams and that lineage of Dean Smith to Roy Williams. And now Carolina man in
pretty good man.
Well, think about it. He was on the bench before and then he went to TV and kind of came back.
22-15.
Growing the leadership standards with a former player who happened to be a roommate of mine during our Pan Am games trials back when we were in college.
Wagner ball Patel here. About it. Going right to left. All in
unfortunately
black.
Unfortunately for him, I tried to put him through.
I think it says Wagner on the
jersey. Some stuff he wouldn't do. So.
Tipped it up. And tipped
right
it in.
By Council. I missed it.
Council.
Got his own and puts it back. Wagner within 5 here.
Council within
Council,
5
his
points.
First made basket. The second made basket, I should say. 2 out of 7. It's Garrett working on Davis. Here's Trimble now.
UNC.
Tocado. Ingram drives it.
Ingram.
And Ingram scores. Good. You see how Harrison Ingram just
24-17.
Got rid of Tajay Kelton.
Tajay. And Tajay recovered. And listen, but here's the thing, though. On the drive, Kelton just, he didn't even really push off. It was just his body weight that pushed Kelton back.
Like he walked into a wall. Scarra. Ingram's just a big boy, man. Scarra got his own but couldn't put it back.
Wagner went with a shot. Look at it back down.
Flat tire on his way up, but a foul is called. Vern Harris calling the foul as Withers was going up with
Withers
bad
went
intentions.
Up. He's getting fouled left and right.
Seth Zongo got him on the arm. And again, foul trouble for the Wagner big men already. So three for Zongo. Keontae Lewis has three already. There's Donald Copeland. He doesn't have a whole lot to turn around and call on.
Three personal fouls for Zongo.
A little different story on the other side.
Yeah.
For Hubert Davis.
A plethora of uniforms that you can use to get in the game. And that's why I said early, how do you play in this physical environment with a big team like North Carolina? Their game plan is to dominate the paint. And so far it's worked because now both of those players have 3-5. So you got to have to play small, which means a lot of switching, and you're going to be susceptible to offensive rebounds by North Carolina.
Council putting the Jets on. Foul on R.J. Davis. The free throws here for Melbourne Council. Hey, watch live men's games on your computer, phone, tablet,
Council
or streaming
going to line
device.
Again.
NCAA March Madness Live. Download now. Stay up to date on all the action.
Now let me say this, too. The counter to that is this. You're small. All guard.
Council.
That means that now.
Good. 25-18.
And Ingram are going to have to guard and defend on the perimeter.
Can 9:56 to go here in the first
get some
half.
Easy shots. Two, can you force them into some foul difficulties themselves by trying to guard on the
within
perimeter
five.
And maybe regulating one or two of those guys to the bench? So
Wagner played two nights
some
ago.
Some guys look at it as a glass half empty. Some look at it as a glass half full.
Well, they go small. They're going to rely on a three-point shot.
Went up.
And good defense, good hands.
Went up for the shot off of a Wagner player.
17 to shoot for Carolina.
Carolina ball.
Better the ball pressure on the passer, the better you'll be trying to defend inside. The ball won't be able to enter as easily.
Back to Baycock. Back to Davis. Davis three. In and out.
Nice save.
Nice save for Withers. Gets it in.
There's the downside of the offensive rebound that Wagner is going to be susceptible to. But excellent play and heads up play to get it back.
Jalen Withers with that save. He's off to a great start here.
Wagner ball here, 26-19.
Carolina big men out guarding these guards because they're all guards.
Shots.
Melbourne
good.
Council with a little mid-range.
Council
jumper.
Looking good. 26-21.
So much in
Council
here.
9 points.
Coming out of Monroe College.
UNC.
He's long, he's athletic, he can guard, he can play.
Going left to right,
positions.
All white North Carolina on their jersey. Misses the shot. Wagner one rebound.
Down. By Teron Allen. There's Council down.
Wagner spins.
Going into the paint.
Baycott and misses.
Clears it away. Trimble, good defense.
Here comes
time.
R.J. Davis. Coast to coast. And he misses the layup.
For Allen.
8:33 to go.
Carolina
Wagner, Council.
In transition.
Take it over here.
Huge size discrepancy on the floor now with Wagner's two big men on the bench with three fouls apiece.
Brown.
Scarra lets it fly. No.
Scarra misses the
rebound.
The
He's going to have a monster rebounding game.
Yeah, Scarra that time a little flat. On that jump shot.
Withers.
Six boards. Now he drives it. Missed it.
Missed it.
The put back.
That was Withers.
Jalen
he went
Withers
up for it, got fouled.
A 3-point play.
And Brian, sometimes you can do everything right. The shot comes up. Withers has a body on him, but guess
Baycock
what?
Baycock went up.
That body
misses.
By Julian Brown is
Withers goes up
short.
And gets fouled in the 3-point play
right there
coming up.
Underneath, and Julian got him, but the size. 6'9 versus 6'1. The ball came right to Withers. Withers able to put it back up now has a chance for old-fashioned three-point play.
Nice little rub here for Jalen Withers as he caps off the three-point trip down the floor. He's got 10 now.
10 for Withers
Six
already.
Of 9 from the free-throw line for Withers.
29-21. Didn't expect well. 8 this.
8-point Carolina lead. Council Jr. guarded by Ingram. Now Baycott switches on to him. Council will cross over, rises up. In and out of goes.
Oh, in and
Baycott.
Out for Council.
Rebound number 7 already.
Here's Baycott.
I tell you what, Baycott with those puppies and took away Council's drive and gets it deep.
Missed the dunk. Baycott and just knocked the guy goes. Over.
Just too big
and we'll get
inside.
The foul.
Wagner doing all they
Wagner
can.
Wagner doing everything they can do to control Baycott, and they can't have it.
Free throw for Baycott when we come back.
All right. Appreciate y'all hanging out. Make sure you're hitting that like button for us and subscribing for NCAA coverage here on the channel. We're having a great day. We're having two more games to go after this. So appreciate y'all hanging out with us. BYU has gone down in your bracket. So if you had BYU, you're one less to a perfect bracket. Or no perfect bracket since BYU's done. So 68-51 Creighton. Looks like there are 7:36 to go on Akron. Long Beach State is down by 10 to Arizona. 18-17 left in the second half. So games coming up at 2:30 is Morehead, 2:30 Central. Morehead State at Illinois, and then 3 o'clock Oregon at South Carolina. So, what's the name of y'all's Valley Sports? See that Roy Williams is at every game, which is a weirdo. Hey, he likes Carolina ball, that's all. Not much to say about that. That's right, Jake. He just likes basketball, you know? Just waiting on the commercial break. You got about 50 more seconds, y'all. I'll be bringing it back to you. .42 seconds. We do have redeem for you guys! !! Redeem Tar Heels with an S, and redeem Wagner, or is it? Yeah, Wagner. Yeah. They're playing on Bally Sports. .31-21. We'll see what kind of team North Carolina comes out in the second half. But right now, they can see that Baycott is unguardable.
Powerade, it takes more. And we're looking at Carolina dominating in the paint. 20 paint points already. Baycott couldn't get the dunk. Does get the finish and the foul. A moment ago, Allie with Donald Copeland.
Well, Coach, you hang your hat on defense. They're shooting close to 70%. There's discrepancy in the points in the paint. What do you want to see cleaned up on the defensive end?
Yeah, we got to make it harder to get into the paint. Game plan was to force them to be shooters right now. They definitely came with a point to get it inside. We're doing a hell of a bad job really protecting the paint. So,
thank you, Coach. I appreciate it.
All business. Donald Copeland, the son of a coach. He replaced Bashir Mason, who
this
has
shot, Wagner
St.
rebound.
Peter's team.
Carolina up by 10.
Playing later today against Tennessee. Those two very close, very good friends. Quite the coaching tree at Wagner. Dan Hurley. Bob Hurley was his assistant. Bashir Mason, now Donald Copeland. Got Wagner with their first NCAA tournament victory. Down by 10. Here is Council. In and out of
Council.
Goes. He's had a couple of those. Another rebound for Baycott.
You know, it's funny. We were talking about it.
Now,
there's
Baycott.
A lot of connectivity in this region. You see a turnover that time by Cadeau with Bashir, Mason, but also Copeland. But then the Zeigler brothers here with
Zakai and Armani.
Yep, here. Yep. You know what I mean? It's like a lot of things in this region.
Well, Paxson Wojcik is on the floor now.
Here we go.
Doug, an assistant at Michigan State.
Council, right? Handed off.
That UNC staff.
Wagner ball.
Early 2000s. Early minutes here for Paxson Wojcik.
The basketball world seems large, but it's very small.
Wasn't too long ago your son was playing in the NCAA tournament.
That's when I was a young Jim.
Three for Wagner. Misses.
That's when I was called Jimmy.
Rebound Wagner.
This is Jim.
Mr. Jackson.
Reset the clock.
Yeah, Mr. Jackson.
Second chance here for
Council.
Wagner. Is Council looking for help?
Great defense by North Carolina closing down the gaps.
Iskara getting late clock here. Ryan's been on him. Now Allen drives it. Allen.
A little in. Allen on Baycock. There you go.
You know, you don't want to get late in the shot clock against this Carolina defense because that's when the size really looms over you. But excellent job that time to finish. But once again that time, Cormac Ryan.
Ryan
able to get his body downhill. And once
up
again, attention
10.
To detail
Five
by
to
North
go.
Carolina. We're not going to bail you out by shooting jump shots. We're going to put our head down, use our size, and force you to have to stop us once we get these big bodies in the paint.
Teron Allen with Ryan on him. Drops his shoulder. Offensive foul.
Offensive foul on Wagner.
Ryan
on
hit
Ryan.
The deck. Allen commits the foul, and now Donald Copeland bringing a big man back on the floor.
Well, Ryan knew it was coming on the second bump. After he received the first one, now he embellished that a little bit more than what it was, but that's just a heads-up play by absorbing the first one, not giving ground, knowing the second one will follow. You bait your opponent into it, and then you use your acting skills a little bit to take advantage of it.
Allen's got three fouls now. Three players for Wagner. Of their seven that have three fouls already. By the way, Wagner's first turnover today. Carolina trying to turn it into points here. They're leading by 10.
Look who's back in the game in his zone defense with three fouls.
Keontae Lewis.
Three.
Ryan
misses.
Wojcik inside, offensive rebound. Ingram looking for help. Wojcik around the horn it goes.
A big
Ryan
three.
Misses another
misses.
Three. Flying high for another offensive rebound.
Baycock.
Ingram.
Ingram and Baycock getting the rebounds
here. Offensive rebound stacking up. Rebound discrepancy.
Three.
A big difference. Five offensive boards. And now Iskara finally secures it. Three shots at it. Carolina can't score. Here's Council on the run. And Council is fouled.
That's Council went up
goes.
For the layup and got
Elvin
fouled.
Council Jr. not afraid. Rolling with his Monroe College teammate here and Tajay Kelton. What a ride it's been for the junior from Rochester. Two free throws for Council.
Council's been working
three
his
out
butt
of four
off
from
here.
The line already. He's already taken 11 shots as well.
This is his
this
free
is
throw.
For the second time. Don't forget to watch whip around coverage of all men's games on your computer, phone, tablet, or streaming device. Fast break presented by AT&T 5G to the March Madness Live app. Download now.
But you know what we've seen? If Wagner can get a stop, they can run on North Carolina.
Sure.
Between Iskara and also, you know, Council Jr.
Right.
Getting out. They can find some ways, but again, the difficult part.
UNC with the ball.
Say that
Davis
you can put a body
bringing
on
it up.
Oversized human beings inside.
Ryan with the
North
ball,
Carolina,
back to Davis.
But that doesn't guarantee you the rebound. You got to root them out and do whatever you can to secure it and get out and run. That's where
Withers
you
is not out there.
Here you got another chance.
A rebound,
right
Wagner.
Found the soft spot in the zone. Couldn't score it, though. Iskara.
4 minutes to go in this half.
Puerto Rico. He gets it right back. Iskara.
Only 33 points put up by the Tar Heels.
Down inside. Keontae Lewis. Guarded by Ingram. Big bodies going at it.
And good. 33-26.
Did you see him peek inside? Bump, bump. Look at the middle of the lane, knowing he had enough room on the baseline to spin and use the glass. So right back out of the zone.
Ingram in that spot once again.
Ingram in and out.
Baycock can't follow it. Baycock gets, a
Baycock gets it. Gets it in.
Puts it in this time. Baycock, double-digit rebound.
Yeah, that's crazy, Matthew. What's up, buddy?
Half already. Got a double-double. 10 points, 11 boards, 3 offensive rebounds.
Yeah, it's a 20-piece coming. this afternoon for him. I mean,
maybe on both sides.
Yeah, he's going to be able to dominate that.
Three. Air ball.
Air ball. Wojcik saves it. Carolina leads by nine.
Air ball by Kelton.
Wagner hanging tough, shorthanded, and in foul trouble.
Peacock went up for the slam and got fouled.
Couldn't finish the dunk. Took a shot in the head. He's got free throws coming.
Yeah, big fella doing his work inside. And not once, the second time, try again, put it inside. It's going to be a big, big afternoon on those boards for Peacock.
All right. We are a commercial break. Appreciate y'all hanging out with us. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribing. Where are we at on the likes? Let's see. Where are we at on the likes? We are at 30 likes. Let's see if we can go to 50. 50 likes is our new goal. On the likes, hit that subscribe button. See if we can get four more to 10,350. See if we can get to that 10,400 mark before the day is over. But thanks very much for hanging out here. Coming up after this game, a little break. And then Texas versus Colorado State. And then Tennessee versus St. Peter's. So two more games on the schedule here for us today. And now, but we will be, hold on a second. All right, just waiting here. 1 minute to go. 1 minute to go. Thanks for subscribing. Appreciate that. Thank you so much. Cam Just. Thanks for the subscribes, guys. Appreciate it. Keep hitting that like button, too. Got 40 seconds and the audio will be coming back here. See if we can get a lot more friends in here watching the game with us. Coming up at halftime, we'll go over the stats. Scores around the nation, and we'll talk some sponsors or partners and just talk some basketball, talk about our brackets. Maybe I can show you my Final Four brackets. We do have redeems. Make sure you got the stream bot telling you about the redeems as well. Here we go.
NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Invesco QQQ, official ETF of the NCAA. Nissan, official partner of March Madness. And by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Back in Charlotte, top-seeded Tar Heels. They lead it 35-26. Wagner coming out of the first four. Coming out of the Northeast Conference. Tournament champions in that conference. Armando Bacot is UNC's record holder for double-doubles and rebounds. And he's already got a double-double here today. 12 points, 11 rebounds. Trying to chase down one of the all-time ACC greats, Tim Duncan.
What? I thought you went to Hawaii.
He is from the islands, but the other islands.
Right.
And Bacot knocks the first one in. We send it over to Ali LaForce. What do you have, Ali?
Well, Brian and Jim, for as dominant as he has been, he comes into this tournament with great humility. He told me, quote, going into this tournament is all we ever wanted, to have a chance to be a number one seed in the tournament. We know it comes with a level of responsibility. He said last season we had a letdown. This year there's an added sense of concentration. And this year we don't take it for granted, and we're ready for it.
King of the NIL, Armando Bacot, 167th game he is playing here today for Carolina.
But didn't that sound like, one, a mature player?
Yeah.
But a player that understands this is his last goal, right?
I love it. And you know, he's so thankful.
37-26 is the score.
I mean, he loves them. They love him. It's been a beautiful marriage all these years.
It has been, but, you know, the realization that it's coming to an end forces you to think and act a lot differently, which it's a great thing to have, and that's why he's played outstanding basketball this entire year.
Up and over, in and out for Wagner. Gets their own rebound. Council. He's been hustling, man.
Get on a little burst here.
37-26. Could Wagner go on a run?
Deontay Lewis playing with the three fouls. Three different Seahawks with three fouls.
He's like,
right,
give me the ball.
Seven-man roster.
Finds it underneath.
Hot pass. Kelton
shoots it up.
Traffic comes up short, and that'll be Carolina ball.
But
Carolina
right ball. There, the ball was stagnant. It was on one side of the court because they figured out either it was Esquerra who had the mismatch with Baycott guarding him, or did they have one inside as well, but not being able to take advantage of it, play right in the hands of North Carolina. And again, you bled under 5 seconds of the shot clock. Hits.
Here we go.
An empty possession.
Davis to Ryan. Baycott.
Shoot three. Country as Ryan rips the cords.
Ryan with a three.
25-year-old, the New York native, started at Stanford, 4 years at Notre Dame, transferred in for one last go-around in the ACC with Carolina. Big lead, biggest lead for the Tar Heels here at 14.
14 now. Wagner
cannot shake Davis.
UNC slowly pulling away here.
Three.
Missed the three. Rebound, UNC. Here comes Davis.
Late in this first half, the lefty, Wojcik.
Missed the three again.
Clears it away. Donald Copeland says, ball control it here. Let's get to the halftime locker room. He's had to navigate with some foul trouble. They've got a great line for their team as we get a foul here by Davis. You know, the seven players, the two bench players, they call them seven jerseys and six polos because that's what their bench looks like. Most of their players in polos or street clothes. And losing key players.
One more
like
subscriber
Moore,
to 10,350.
Zaire Williams, Rob Taylor, all players with significant injuries that does not have them available here for the NCAA tournament.
Well, keep in mind to our fans that haven't seen Wagner play.
Wagner ball, 40-26.
Just happened in the tournament.
UNC, 59 seconds left in his half.
With seven players.
Council.
Great point. Four to shoot.
On Swithers.
Council. No.
Oh, Council made a nice play.
Offensive board. Kelton can't get it to go. And finally, Jalen Withers. And that's a turnover.
And how many turnovers have we seen
there
from North Carolina?
Thank you for that subscribe.
With their outlet passes.
Good point. Five turnovers overall. Wagner wants a chance to talk it over with the ball in their hands. Down 14.
All right, down 14. Let's take a look at some stats here. North Carolina shooting 51% from the field. Wagner 30% on the three-point shot. 26% or 29% for our UNC. 20% or 28.6% from the field three-point line for UNC, and 20% for Wagner. Both with five turnovers for UNC, big time. Only one for Wagner, which is shocking here as a 16 seed going against this other team here. So make sure you're hitting that like button as you're coming in. Appreciate y'all all the love here today as we're doing the North Carolina versus Wagner live audio of the CBS feed, and we're having a good time here. Looks like Creighton and Arizona will advance. Yep, so Arizona's up 62-41. Creighton 75-60. As you know, BYU lost, so... but coming up right after this, we're going to be, at 5:50 Central, we're going to be bringing you the live audio of the Texas versus Colorado State, and that should be a good game. We watched the Colorado State game the other day, so. CeeLo, what's up, Andrew? CeeLo, you know how I was going to the Tennessee game tonight? Well, I'm not. Oh, man, that sucks. That sucks. But appreciate the ones that are just coming in here. Thank you so much for hanging out with us. Texas, Colorado State, and then Tennessee versus St. Peter's tonight. And that'll be our complete slate of games here on the Go at CeeLo. We're just waiting on the audio to come back here, and we'll bring it back to you. We're about 30 seconds away from the audio. Coming up halftime, we'll be giving you our stats of both teams and talk about some other stuff. 17 seconds here. Coming in. Keep on hitting that subscribe. Keep on hitting that like button as we're trying to get to 50 likes. We almost made it to 100 likes last stream, so let's see if we can do it again. 4, 3, 2, 1, and back at it.
Well, right, he wants a timeout. Above, other side of half court to be able to run a play, Donald Copeland is imploring Julian Brown to get there. Keep in mind, Donald Copeland in high school played for Bob Hurley Sr. St. Anthony. So the attention to detail, the little things, the discipline, and you take that he had a disciplinary as a father.
Yes.
You know that's translated to his coaching.
38 seconds to go, shot clock 20.
I told you, his players know he's the worst thing they have to face every day, and he was on their case in that last time.
They're going to play here to get within 11.
No look.
Two. Good. Lewis with a shot. 40-28.
Once again, out of a timeout, a beautiful drawn-up play. The execution was there because he understands Copeland's a timeout by North Carolina. Their margin of error is very small.
Take a break with the Tar Heels. They'll have a last shot if they want it when we come back.
All right, another timeout. Don't you love a couple minutes left in a college basketball game? So if you're just coming in, let me see where you're from. Are you for the Tar Heels? And if you're here for Wagner, I want you to speak up, and I want to see go Seahawks. I want to see it, unless your favorite, you're an 8-9 team below North Carolina. I want to see go Seahawks or go Heels. Let me see who you got. I'm curious to see who's with us today. It sure is all Tar Heel fans, but if not, let me see go Tar Heels or go Seahawks. And if you're a Seahawk fan, please speak up. Please speak up. I want to see if a Seahawk fan got to us.
TNT at the half. Armando Baycott with 14
go Heels.
Points,
Tyler says go
rebounds.
Heels. Jake.
R.J. Davis, relatively quiet thus far. They really haven't needed Davis' shooting at this point, dominating in the paint. L.A. Cadell, the freshman, will get it organized. Clock ticks. They'll take it to the end. Wagner, a very good defensive team. Davis finds some space. Lost the handle.
Davis lost it, and that's it.
To the halftime locker room.
Go Heels, William.
Was fired up on the sideline. Looked like he was playing point guard for Seton Hall once again. Wagner down 12 to the top-seeded Tar Heels. Halftime in round one. North Carolina and Wagner. The 16-1 matchup. AT&T at the half. Coming your way next.
All right, AT&T at the half coming up. Carolina 40, Wagner Seahawks 28. Did you think it would be this close? John, one of our friends that hangs out here, he said it might be UNC by 50 or the 25 is too easy. But I went with the under, and the over-under was 130, I believe. So I went with the under. That might be, I don't know, 68. That might be it. And Creighton won. So Creighton defeats Akron 77-60. Arizona is coming down to the wire on Long Beach State 62-43. We have a live ticker here for you guys. Give you the scores and highlights if you haven't done those. 40-28. So looks really good. Word up. What's up, Urban Family Ventures? What's going on, man? Can't wait to see your new stuff. Should be fun. Braves won 5-2. Awesome. So like 10 more likes to 50, help us get to 50 likes, and we'll move on from there and see what they say during the half here. Let you listen in, then we'll go over some highlights and see why the game is. The game's on CBS. Yes, it is. CBS. No gym dance this year. He's done with the college basketball, which sucks because he's always been good to listen to. He's a great sportscaster. So, but make sure you guys are coming back here, after halftime. Make sure you're coming back. UNC needs to stop turning it over. Yeah. So UNC's got 6 turnovers. Who would have thought that UNC would have six turnovers compared to Wagner with one. UNC trying to throw those long passes across court as well. But they were clearly, Wagner clearly can't stop Baycock or Withers. Like, they keep on fouling Withers left and right. Davis really hasn't done much. Davis, what has he got? RJ Davis has got 5 points. That's crazy. Let's listen in to the half. See what they got to say about UNC. This should be interesting.
I would say Armando Baycott came to work today, ready to go. Double-double in the first half of this one. And the North Carolina Tar Heels, number one seed, playing in Charlotte and leading 40-28 over the Seahawks of Wagner. Welcome to AT&T at the half. Ernie Johnson here in our New York studio with Clark Kellogg, Kenny the Jet Smith, of course, noted Tar Heel, and Charles Barkley. What'd you think, Jet, of your alma mater?
I mean, it's still a slow start. I think, the enthusiasm is probably the only thing that I haven't seen, but the execution has been there. Armando be able to carve space down. When the Tar Heels shoot threes, then it really opens up the space. But they made a concerted effort to say, you guys are too small. So we're going to drop it down to Baycott. We're going to drop it down to Harrison Ingram. We're going to make sure that you play interior defense, and then we'll work our way back out.
Mm-hmm. First half belonging to the Tar Heels. Couple of highlights from the first 20 minutes to show you. R.J. Davis, of course, when you think about this team, first guy that comes to mind, well, Baycott also, but R.J. knocks down the long ranger.
Player of the year, baby. Yeah, he's had a terrific senior season, All-America, but that's the guy who's been making it happen. Points in the paint. That's a nice follow-up shot, Jalen Withers. And 24-12 points in the paint, as you would expect, with the advantage that North Carolina has over the much smaller Wagner team. So it'll be kind of yeoman's work, yes. Methodically done.
Yes.
It's a hallmark of all those North Carolina teams, the ability to get on the boards and dominate that statistic. 25 rebounds in the first half, 25-14 the advantage. Chuck, what'd you think?
Well, I think, number one, I said before the game, Baycott was going to be huge. He's just too big, too strong for the little guys down in the paint, and that was the difference. But what that's going to open up, Ernie, is that dreaded three-point shooting. As a coach, you have to make a decision. They were letting Baycott go one-on-one. You look at all these plays, he's one-on-one. They're not, he's just
get that one and get it back.
Just too big, too strong. And so I give a coach credit, saying like, hey, you know what? We can't give up threes, but now the size advantage took over. Now he's going to have to make the adjustment. And if he make the adjustment that we're going to stop Baycott, then they're going to start raining threes on him.
Wagner coming in, season high 4-game winning streak. They've been coming in shorthanded. They've been coming in with all kind of injuries. And then you kind of step up a weight class here today against the Tar Heels, Clark.
No question about it. I mean, and that's typically what you anticipate when you see a 116 play. I know we've had two 16s win in the last 5 years, but typically this is what you're going to see, a team that's a little overmatched, well, significantly overmatched, and the Tar Heels in full control here.
Yeah, it's a 12-point game at the break. Winner of this game knows who they're going to get in the next round, and that's because the first game of the day was Michigan.
All right, so we watched that one, Michigan State from Mississippi State. So let's look at some scores here around the nation, or stats from this game. And let me get that here for you guys 1 second, as they're still at halftime. We'll bring back the live audio as soon as we go back live. But let me look at the North Carolina score right here. But the North Carolina is going to play Michigan State. The whole Michigan State-North Carolina game, that would be a good second round matchup there. But let's take a look at the team stats really quick. And let me do this real quick. Make sure I have the right thing. But, yeah. And, all right, so let's take a look at the team stats real quick here for the game. 11 for 34 for Wagner, 14 for 27 for North Carolina, 51%. From the field for the North Carolina Tar Heels. 2 for 10 from the three-point line for Wagner. Only 2 for 7 for UNC. So both of them cannot hit the threes. But like he just said, you know, they start guarding Baycock. dish it out. Let's hit the three and let's move on. We'll see how that goes. Free throws, 4 for 6 for Wagner, 10 for 14 for UNC. They are fouling left and right, 71% for them. Rebounds, North Carolina all day, 25 to 14. Assist, 5 for North Carolina, 4 for Wagner. Steals, 3 steals for Wagner. That's weird. No blocks for either team. 6 total turnovers for Wagner, or for North Carolina, and only 9 points off those turnovers. 1 turnover for Wagner. Wagner playing smart here. I thought Mississippi was going to beat Michigan. I so too, Jacob. Let's see. Fast break points, 2 for Wagner, none for North Carolina. Points in the paint, 24. The big man, Baycock, and Withers both doing their thing. 24 points down there. 9 fouls for Wagner, 5 for North Carolina. The largest lead is 14. So let's look at the play box scores here really quick before we get back here. Let me make sure we're live. We're still at a commercial break. Okay. Kay Lewis, he's got 8 points. Council, he seems like he's had the ball all the time, is 10. Brown's got 8. Most assists right now. Rope rebounds is 3 for Council. Let's look at the Tar Heels thing there. Ingram with 4. Of course, Baycock down front there in the middle. 11 rebounds. He's already got a double-double. 11 rebounds, 14 points. 5 for RJ Davis. No points for Ryan. All right, 5 points for Ryan, sorry. Washington, let's see. Withers has got 10, and they keep on fouling him like crazy. Foul trouble. Let's see. Allen for Wagner's got 3, and Lewis has got 2. So there's that. Full scoreboard here. Long Beach, Arizona, 70 to 53, almost over. Look at them dropping the Tar Heels. Okay, we're still good. Wagner. Then there's Morehead State over Illinois right now. That's a big one. The 3 seed, Illini, down 17-13 early in the first. Then Oregon, South Carolina, Nevada, Dayton, Colorado State, Texas, Oakland, Kentucky, McNeese. That's a big one. I'm going to watch that one tonight. I'm going to keep track of that one tonight. South Dakota, Iowa State, St. Peter's, Tennessee will be doing that game. North Carolina, Texas, Samford at Kansas. Could be an upset alert there. Drake, Washington State. Creighton beats Akron, 77-60. Their big man had 23 points. Quinze brings down BYU, 71-67. And Michigan State takes down Mississippi State. So that is that on that. So hope you guys enjoyed the little halftime show there. And let me make sure we're refreshed here. All right, let's see our social media here. Make sure you're checking out our social media. Make sure you follow me on all sorts of things over here. Oh, that's the wrong one. This is the right one. There's our social media. On the Go at CeeLo is our Facebook page. CeeLord16 is our Twitter. On the Go at CeeLo1 is our Instagram. And On the Go at CeeLo is our TikTok. We're streaming on Twitter right now and Twitch and YouTube. So make sure you guys say hello on all that. Jalen. All right, back at it here. Listen in.
Could get. You know, he's talking about the spotlight. He's talking about prime time, you know, giving a chance for his players in on that stage. Somebody might think, oh, well, if you're Kentucky and you hear, well, this is the best matchup we went. But you got to understand how tight these guys
That's
are.
Right.
So
That's
there
right.
was no disrespect. In
None at all. It's about relationship, yeah. a history of relationship, quality relationship, and a shared profession. So you understand exactly what it feels like when you're going against a friend.
What's up, Curtis? What's going on, buddy?
And not only that, I just remember even back when I was recruited, like they will send you pictures of them playing. Schools will send you pictures of them playing Duke, North Carolina, Kentucky. They're not going to send you pictures of
brand names.
No,
right.
Brand names. They're like, this is who we play if you come here.
Yeah.
So this is another, that's what he's saying, a spotlight and opportunity. And if you win, then the spotlight goes bigger. Ask St. Peter's and ask our guy now at Seton Hall how it changes your life over a couple of weekends.
But also, this is about Kentucky. At some point, they got to make a deep run. They can't keep getting upset. I mean, they're the University of Kentucky. They're one of the greatest programs in history. And Cal is a terrific coach and a good friend. But at some point, he can't keep living off what happened during the Anthony Davis era. He got to go deep in this tournament at some point, and this might be the year.
That is the 14-3 matchup later right here on CBS. Meantime, 14 seed, Morehead State, taking on the Fighting Illini of Illinois, number 3.
All right, so just letting him talk a little bit more about that Kentucky game. We talked about Travel Depot. Make sure you go check out my man, Majestic Triton Travel. He'll get you a Disney hookup. Get you a Disney, Universal, anything Disney Cruises, anything Orlando. My man, Majestic Triton Travel, can take care of you. And Morehead State up 19-16. That is crazy. Back out of here.
Morehead State with a three-point lead. But, Chuckster, it is early as you take a look at the Illini and Morehead State.
Yeah, but I like the way Morehead came out. They're playing with tremendous confidence. A couple of those threes they made, you're like, those are only good shots because they go in. They're not afraid. But like I said, Illinois is playing as well as any team coming into this tournament. They're right up there with UConn, who's playing great, Auburn, who's playing great, North Carolina, who's playing great. So I expect Kenny to
say hello.
Yeah, but I'm really looking forward because, like I say, man, when in a one-and-done scenario, we've already seen it earlier today with Duquesne. It ain't best of seven. It's best of one day, and anything can happen.
Yeah, wondered, too, what the layoff would be like for Morehead State. The last game they played was March 9th, almost 2 weeks since they've played, but out of the gate well in this one. Second half is coming up, but now let's learn how to connect to the madness with coaches J.B. Smoove and Kayla at AT&T Connect U.
All right, so coming back here to the second half, make sure you're hitting that like button and subscribing to the channel. Let's see if we can get to 10,360 on the subscribe as we're going back to the second half here very shortly with the Tar Heels up 40-28. We'll see if the Tar Heels can pull this off here. So make sure you're sharing the stream out, liking it on Facebook as well. Go over there and like the stream on Facebook on our post over there. That kind of helps the algorithm as well. But as they're slowly coming back in here again, ready for the second half. Tar Heels, see if they can pull this away, start draining the threes, and move on to Michigan State, which will be a tough matchup come on Saturday. Les Wagner goes on a run here and shocks them. Wouldn't that be something? The Tar Heels go down. Be crazy. One more minute, we'll be back to live audio of the game. Lewis with 8 points, Council 10. He's got the most shots, 3 of 13. He's been everywhere. Council's had the ball everywhere. Baycock there. We'll see if this is a Baycock show this second half here. So did they get rid of him finally? Let's see. Still up. Oh, okay, that's that. One's still up. I can't believe it. Nine seconds to go, and we'll bring it in. Oh, yeah, we got to do that one.
Can Charlotte, and a reminder, Monday on CBS, grab your gear, join the NCIS team as they investigate an international crime with family ties. A new episode of NCIS Monday, 9, 8 Central. Wagner College, Staten Island, New York, the 16th seed, trying to hang in there with the beast from the ACC, North Carolina. Second half coming your way from Charlotte after this.
All right. Second half coming up. Another commercial. NCAA is full of commercials. NASCAR and NCAA, they love them commercials. Represent my volunteer nation today with my volunteer cup for tonight. Ready for the game tonight. Tennessee Volunteers. So, last stream we had over 200 in here. Let's see if we can get that again before it ends. We had 200 in here for a while, but that was the first game of the night. UNC is just a little more popular. UNC is just a little more popular. So let me see your predictions on the end of this game. The line was 25. Do you think UNC wins by 25? Yes or no? 133 that are here. Does UNC win by 25? Bless you. Let me see your predictions in the chat. Does UNC win by 25? We're almost to 50 likes. Five more likes to 50. Help us get to 50 likes. What's up, Curtis? Curtis, you get that Martin Truex hat yet? No NASCAR this weekend also, Curtis.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Capital One. What's in your wallet? Colo Guard. The U.S. Army, be all you can be. And by Dove Beauty Bar.
Moments away from half number two here in Charlotte, the 16 seed, the Wagner Seahawks. They trail by 12, top seeded Carolina Tar Heels, just a couple of hours. From their home gym, enjoying a big crowd here at Jim Jackson. North Carolina, certainly a size discrepancy. The guys talked about that during our AT&T at the half. And Armando Bacot just taking control here.
You know, against a normal team, the size is an issue, let alone a team that is smaller and only have seven scholarship players available to play. And you saw it in the first half. Is that the game plan by Hubert Davis and the coaching staff is what? Dominate the paint. Whether that's 2 feet in the paint off the dribble or post-ups, offensive rebounds, they didn't abandon it. And I love the maturity in which North Carolina played in that first half, because when you're able to dominate like that, the tendency is to kind of chuck up some shots. They didn't do that, hence you walk into halftime with a 12-point lead.
That was Sterling Drives presented by Nissan. Now we turn it over to Allie LaForce. You had a chance to hear from Donald Copeland.
That's right. He said the big focus was, I need North Carolina to shoot more threes, force them to take their attempts from deep. They only attempted seven total threes in the first half. He said, I thought we did a great job getting back in transition. He was also very happy with offensively the looks they were getting, the fact that they haven't turned the ball over
a lot. Wagner inbound here.
To get to the free throw line more, but his main focus was forcing them to
shoot more
from
deep.
Yeah, that's a good call, Allie. Thank you. Just one turnover for Wagner. You see the Tar Heels. 46-1.
There's the turnover. He just said it.
Going into the second half, they force a turnover right away on the run.
Wagner all over him. He says they didn't do a turnover. RJ Davis misses the brick.
Didn't need him much.
But rebound out of bounds. Who's got the ball?
A couple of empty sets. First possession for each team coming out of the halftime locker room.
And I want to say
bounds off of UNC.
No slight at Wagner. seventh in the country in Division I and holding opponents to 62.3 points. That's in the NEC. That sometimes doesn't translate to that same number when you're facing a North Carolina. So you can lean into that. That's your calling card. But sometimes against an opponent that's far more
Wagner misses
superior
the little layup there.
Depth,
here comes UNC.
That number is not the same. It doesn't equate the same.
Yeah, good point. Ellie Cadeau with an offensive foul. So Carolina turns it over. The
freshman point guard
Cadeau. New
Keep
Jersey.
Hitting that like
native button
and subscribe, y'all.
Quiet afternoon for him thus far.
More
they
important.
With 14
subscribe.
Points, 12 rebounds. Already
a Wagner ball again.
Jalen Withers having one of his best games of the year. Just the fourth time all year he's been in double figures. Charlotte native coming off the bench with 10 and 5 boards. Deontay Lewis backing down Baycott. Lewis, little jump
good.
Up is good. Got himself in foul
40-30.
First half with three quick ones. They're going to need him to play smart if they're going
to
have a chance
to go here.
Wagner within 10. R.J.
Davis
trying to get by Ascara. Nice little floater.
And out Wagner with the rebound.
Yeah, a little crowded space that time with Davis dribbled through. And look at the speed at which Council was able to get down the court. And that's what I said in the first half is that if you can get stops, enough stops, and get out and run, now those big bodies are not camped into the lane, and you can find yourself with either an open jump shot or, like you saw Melvin Council Jr. do right there, able to attack off the dribble and get to the free throw line.
Cormac Ryan picks up the foul, is going to send Council to the free throw line. 21 against Howard in the first four on Tuesday. Only made one three-pointer in that game, and he missed all three of his free throws in that game. Not a great free throw shooter. He has been the only Wagner Seahawk to take free throws in this game, and he's 4 for 8 now.
40-30, lead is 10.
The shots were short, no air underneath him.
Ryan with a three. Drilled it.
Pure stroke.
Ryan with a three.
Missed two. Game plan is to make North Carolina make three.
43-30, lead is 13. Wagner with the ball.
So kind of a 5-point swing right there in favor of Carolina.
Three made threes for the Tar Heels. Cormac Ryan has two of them. Just underway here at half number two.
Up.
That was the high
and good
the
off
half.
The backboard.
43-32. With a little mid-range jump shot. We'll see he did that on purpose.
Baycock with the ball. Back to Ryan. Thought about shooting a three. Cadeau
inside
back
Baycock.
To Baycock
position,
not going to stop
Baycock.
Him there
missed it.
Oh,
another chance here for Carolina.
Back Baycock again
up. Baycock again there's contact,
and gets fouled
and
this time
number 4 on Keontae Lewis.
Make 4 fouls on their big man. That's not good.
And Lewis with the body contact on Baycock.
But what a heads up play by Cormac Ryan, and I say that because instead
he's
of
going
toe to toe
with
shot,
Baycock.
Baycock tipped it out. He went right back to him in the post. And as a result, you're able to pick up another foul on Keontae Lewis.
Well, Donald Copeland trying to avoid foul trouble. Going to be tough to avoid against a team like North Carolina. Three with three fouls. And Allen and Zongo and Lewis are the front court players. It's been a wild ride here for Wagner after winning the first four games. Didn't arrive until 3 a.m. They were back at it film session at 11 a.m. yesterday and then out here for the workout. They went hard in practice, too. Now, they don't go full contact,
no.
But they
Wagner go ball
hard.
Here.
Yeah, they stopped going full contact once out. The bodies began short. So you lose
Wagner to the basket all over. Small guy over big guy, and he turns
well,
it over.
That's the cards that they were dealt
here
with.
Comes UNC. Ooh, a slapper.
Council from behind with
Council.
A block. Last touch by Baycott. That's going to be Wagner ball. What a play by Melvin Council.
But just on cue, Donald Copeland, his team, they don't give up. Council could have easily laid back, but he went right after this and took this away from Cadeau, who thought that was easy money in transition.
What an image. Council.
Here we go.
Purpose. Now he's
to the basket.
The
no,
handle.
Strips away. Council gets
into
stripped away again.
Harrison Ingram.
Here they come.
13-point Carolina lead. Ingram backing down a much smaller player.
Ryan faked the three.
Ryan gives it up.
R.J. Davis.
Baycott.
Baycott's going to slowly push his way. Manhandle.
Baycott leads it for Davis. Goal. Wow,
Davis. Baycott to Davis, and it's good.
Somehow got it off the window.
Tough finish that time, but
47-32.
Defense and Davis. Able to pick his poison right there. Open shot or drive off the catch. Took the easier one, made a tough shot inside.
Just 7 points for Davis. He led the ACC in.
Keep hitting that subscribe button if you haven't subscribed yet. Shoot up.
That's
blocked
by Davis, but a foul. Got him on the wrist. RJ Davis commits the foul on the Julian Brown jumper. Free throws for Brown when we continue from Charlotte.
All right, let me refresh this because I think it's just a little behind here.
AT&T just sent me a heads up on the...
All right, so I got it muted there. Got it back to normal. 47-32. If you guys want to become a member of our channel, it's 99 cents. And that's the rookie level. That's the lowest level you can get. And you get access to emojis. And here's the emojis that we have here. We had some for Mississippi State, but they were out. But we have one left in there. But I'll be changing those up. But we have a couple Tar Heel emojis in there. We got our games that are coming up tonight as well. We got the Texas in there, the Longhorns, and all those good too. Do I have a Longhorns? Yeah, I do have a Longhorns in there. So there's our emojis that we have. So if you guys would like to become a member, you have access to those. It's 99 cents. And we also have Pro, which you have early access to vlogs if I release one. And MVP, you get all of that above. Plus, you get a special live stream on Monday nights. So what's up? Yep, so there's Urban Family Adventures. He's a member. Terminator's a Gator's a member as well. So great time. We have a good time on our Monday night streams when we're able to someone to join. So that is our access for our MVP. But just 99 cents for emojis is a pretty cheap deal. So, all right. I was waiting on the access to come back here. 26 seconds left of this audio. And see if we can get some more folks in here. Keep on hitting that like button for us and subscribing to the channel. We're trying to get to 10,360. Appreciate the subscribe. 10,360 is our next goal to get there. Slowly get to that 10,400 mark tonight. Hopefully. We'll see. Back at it. Here we go.
Talk brackets with a friend? Just tell Siri. Text.
Oh, not yet. Still commercials. Now it's back on.
Look from our AT&T connected cam, Armando Baycott.
Yeah, well, the grad senior, I mean, he's seen every kind of defensive matchup in the world. So very patient and comfortable, more importantly, with that, able to drop that dime to RJ Davis. And when you have that kind of combination, you read off of each other and communicate without speaking. That time, body language said, get your butt to the paint. I'm going to drop it to you. You got to get two.
Free throws for Julian Brown. So he's the first Wagner Seahawk other than Council to be at the line here. Brown, excellent three-point shooter.
37-33. Wagner's still in this.
Played all 40
it ain't a blowout yet.
Tuesday
thanks for that new subscribe.
Those two clutch free throws late in the game that put him up three. Knocks them both down here.
Curtis.
You got to figure
Massenburg, thank
this,
you for that
this
subscribe.
This 5-minute window right now is the game for them. They're down 13. They get a couple of free throws. Trying to tighten up the anxiety.
Wagner has not
on
gone
the
away.
Seed.
Set Ryan
on the floor,
looking.
The
defense
bench
is great for Wagner. RJ Davis.
Three, comes up
Rick.
Lewis,
rebound big man for Wagner.
Positive defensive possession and in transition. So
Euro from
47-36. Lead is 11.
Nice. He has got some serious.
Thank you, Curtis. Appreciate it.
Cormac Ryan comes right back to lay it in and a foul. And Ryan is headed to the line.
Ryan gets a three-point play here.
Council. A little bit of that in his game right here. Look at this. Able to get it down quickly before, but then you give it back up. Really, you see Wagner give it up, and then that time Keontae Lewis is forced
49-36
to the bench with his fourth foul. And those are fouls that you would rather him use on Armando Bacot or a postman down low, not in that situation because of the transition defense just wasn't intact that time.
So a good 50, answer by 36.
Just as Wagner gets close
with the traditional three-point play. He's had hit two threes as well in the game. He's got 11. Esquera letting it set Zongo now. Looking around the perimeter. Now Council goes to work.
Shoots it up. Wagner misses. Bacot rebound. Another one for
Bacot
him.
Bacot collects his 14th rebound.
14th rebound.
16 points, 14 boards for Armando Bacot.
Bacot throws it across. Ball back across again, inside, back to Bacot,
resets,
and spins and good. Got too beat. Easy.
And Armando Bacot with a left hand.
The offensive Bacot double-double, 18 points. Take the best shot by North Carolina. You know, when you
what's
have
up,
a size
Steven?
Lead,
what's going on?
Sometimes you try some things
of course,
to go off script, but we haven't seen that yet. So outstanding offensive discipline by the Tar Heels.
There's a scare.
What up?
Leave it up
Wagner.
Bacot
just picks it up like it's nothing.
Pass.
RJ Davis, coast to coast. And good.
And scores another one. Donald Copeland, sensing a moment here, needs a timeout. It's a 7-0 Carolina run.
A top player in the ACC doesn't have to force his offense, especially when you get easy ones in transition like that.
Davis went coast to coast there, took it to the basket himself, and now Carolina finds himself up 54-36 here in the second half. 13 minutes to go, long ways to go, but slowly North Carolina pulling themselves away. Appreciate everybody being here. Make sure you're hitting that like button for us. We're trying to get to 50 likes. Let's see. Are we there yet? Are we there yet? Let's see. We're at 46 likes, so if hit that like button. See if we there's 158 of us here. I'm sure someone hasn't hit the like button yet or subscribed. We're trying to get to 10,360. Help us get there. And then let's take a look at some of the stats real quick. North Carolina has got, 51% from the field? Three-point shot, 30% from UNC. On the Wagner side, 35% from the field for Wagner and only 20% from the three-point line. Turnovers should be, you would think, would be the other way around. 7 turnovers for the Tar Heels. They played really sloppy in the first half, but they're getting their act together now. Bacot just taking over, and then only 4 turnovers for Wagner. So good for them. Not playing stupid, not giving up bad passes. Only 4 turnovers for them. And then the rebounds, it's been all Bacot. 30 rebounds for UNC to 18 for Wagner. Just Matt, they're Wagner's big guy. He's got 3 fouls, I believe. Let's see if I can find it here. Lewis, yeah, Lewis has got the 3 fouls. He's been on the bench for a while. Ever since Lewis went off, he was the only one that really could stand up to Bacot. But Lewis is on the bench. He's 5-for-7. He's got 10 points, though, but he's got 3 fouls. So nobody really in foul trouble other than Davis. He's got 2. So hope everybody's having a good time. Hope everybody had a great time today. Let's go Tar Heels. Frederick, what's going on? How you doing, sir? Appreciate you being here. So keep hitting that like button, subscribing to the channel, as we're going to be live again around 5:50 Central, Texas versus Colorado State, right here on the channel. And we would love for you to join us tonight for another basketball game. And then right after that, about 30, 40 minutes after that, Tennessee versus St. Peter's, my boys playing tonight. So hope to see you guys there. So our second game of the afternoon, we've got a full slate of games today and now tomorrow. And the next 3 days I'll be off. I got some vacation going on, but we'll be definitely bringing some more UN basketball to you guys very shortly next week. So thank you guys for being here.
This April Paramount Plus. Jim Nantz leading the coverage. Jim Nantz not a part of March Madness this year. First time in a long, long time. Iron Eagle take it over the top seat. He'll be on the air from Brooklyn tomorrow with Grant Hill, Bill Rafter, Tracy Wolfson. I'll be right here on CBS. You get to see One of the 3-1 seeds in action tomorrow on CBS. UConn setting up shop in Brooklyn this week. Wagner with the ball here.
Three for Wagner. Drills it.
Julian Brown coming out of that.
Brown with another three. It's
his third three-pointer. 15 for Julian Brown.
Brown, 15 points. Still not going away is this Wagner Seahawk team.
Ball control for Carolina.
Back and forth.
Back Davis. Iscara's been on Davis.
Ryan three. Airballed it. A rebound, North Carolina.
Chance for the heels.
And RJ Davis.
Down to two.
2 seconds. You better shoot it.
On him. Ryan does get it off.
And in and out.
Rebound secured.
Rebound Wagner.
Offensive rebound, Carolina not able to take advantage of it, but here in transition, secondary break, get an open shot. Yeah.
Three-pointer for Tajay Kelton.
Kelton with a three.
Gotta be a thrill for Kelton and Council. Those two teammates at Monroe College now on the big
54-42,
stage.
Wagner's
the
not
NCAA
going away.
Tournament. Wagner hitting a couple of threes in the last two possessions to make this a 12-point Carolina lead.
Three for Ryan.
Comes up short. Offensive board. Withers. Withers has been a beast in
good
one today and puts one back.
In the size matters.
56-42 again. Wagner goes to the basket. Shoots up two. Air ball.
From Kelton. Little push shot. Comes up short.
12 minutes to go.
Threading the
needle. Baycock underneath.
Can't finish.
And good. Withers tips it in.
How about that pass from Davis and Baycott Abel? You like this, scooped it up almost
58-42.
Pickett, short hop.
There you go.
Pickett Wilson. That was a good catch by Baycott.
It was.
Turned it into points after the miss.
Withers able to, all the attention was on Baycott, so that window was open for him to tip it back in.
Wagner ball here, top of the baseline to the basket. Withers gets in front.
On the floor, Withers got him.
Withers fouls.
Timeout. Carolina up 58-42. 15 second chance points just dominating the glass.
Big man. Like I said, Lewis went out and Baycock just took over. Baycock in double-double already. 14 rebounds. He's got 16 points. He's 6 for 11 from the field. He's 14 rebounds, 1 assist. He's only got 1 personal foul. Baycock with authority tonight. Davis, he's got 9 points, 1 for 4 from the 3-point line, 4 for 9 from the field. So, hope everybody's had a good day. Hope everybody approves of the broadcast for you guys. I hope you guys are liking it. 164 here. Could be more, but we'll see before we get to the end of this game. But appreciate all of y'all. Cheers for y'all. Cheers. About a minute and 40 seconds left. We talked about Travel Depot. We talked about my social media. Let's see here. I don't think I have anything else. But thanks for all the new subscribers today. Thank you so much for all the likes and love. What's going on here? No raid, Kenneth Clark. Understand, though. No raid, buddy. No raid. Definitely do some during baseball, for sure. Definitely do some baseball raids, for sure. We'll definitely do some raids during baseball. A little slower of a sport. You don't have that much time to go over there. Basketball is just so quick. Baseball is a little more slower between innings and stuff like that. So, plus, during the day, I don't think there's anybody that's doing any games that are broadcasting anything. Plus, if we had a lot more folks in here that were chatting, Braves win 5-2 today. Nice. Mm-hmm. It's a year to be a fan of the Tar Heels, Frederick says. We'll see. I have Tar Heels going to the Final Four. I think I have him in the championship game against, I think UConn, UNC, but then I have UConn in the finals, but we'll see what happens here. Coming back here, 1 second.
I'm Jamie Erdahl back in New York with this Intuit TurboTax Moves of the Game. Arizona avoids a repeat 15-seed upset with a no-doubt 85-65 outing against Long Beach State. Caleb Love had a double-double after transferring away from North Carolina a year ago. Back to Seahawks Tar Heels, B.A., Jim, and Allie.
Yeah, Jamie, you could see a matchup down the road.
Yeah, UNC, Arizona, that would be something.
Caleb Love, R.J. Davis, Caleb Arizona, Love. UNC.
Another three. Wagner won't go away. Wagner
getting a corner three-pointer, so the three-point shooting has kept them hanging around here. Only down
58-45.
Has 18 points now.
Brown.
His fourth made three. Ingram showed three.
18 points for Brown.
Back in the hands of the point guard. Deflection.
Almost a
by
turnover
Brown.
There.
Davis now tries.
Davis goes down hard.
RJ Davis hangs, is fouled. And RJ Davis will go to the line for a pair.
Great attack that time. And I'll tell you what, another outstanding out of bounds, out of timeout play by Donald Colton. Yep. Drawn up. Now listen, you may not make the shot, but do you get the shot that you want and not what the defense dictates? And that has to be four or five times that they've gotten an outstanding look and been able to convert coming off of a timeout.
Just 40 years of age, Donald Copeland.
RJ Davis, year. 21 points per game.
For this year, Mason. And you can tell the skill of a coach on those out-of-bounds plays.
Davis has
drawn up a few
10 points.
In this one. Hey, CBS, Tuesday is FBI night. FBI, FBI International, FBI Most Wanted. New episodes Tuesday starting at 8, 7 Central.
See what happens
all new,
here.
All spring on CBS.
Keep that like button and subscribe. And
on Paramount Plus as well. RJ Davis with a couple of free throws. Jalen Washington will enter for Carolina.
So Baycock off the court.
Will sit. 18 points, 14 rebounds for Armando Baycott. It's a 15-point Carolina lead.
60-45.
Yeah, 11 offensive rebounds, 15 second chance points, and 36 of the 60 points by North Carolina.
Wagner get another three.
Brown turning the corner. Two-man
Brown to
here.
The dish.
And a
foul on the three-point play again.
Strong roll to the rim. Zongo a chance at a three-point play.
But pace,
let's go Heels, Brad says.
Play an opportunity to work. You come off the screen hard. You roll hard. Now the defense is shifting. That little pocket pass was available. And Zonga able to, despite that
Zonga.
Thin frame.
Completes the three-point play. And they won't go away, y'all.
Wagner, you,
within
you
12.
Then they make a little bit of a push, get this thing back to 12.
Tough team here. Sexongo, the freshman
UNC.
On the shorthanded roster, and with Taron Allen with four fouls right now, he's going to have to play some big minutes. Back
RJ wide open,
Davis
drains it.
Three-pointer.
Well, you know, that skip pass
Davis
is
with
always
the big three.
Susceptible to an open shot, and unfortunately, that open shot lands in the hands of a 41% three-point shooter with R.J. Davis.
Back and forth with threes here.
You want to take that shot.
Davis
Wagner.
Out of five.
Right coming in, hit that left button.
Today, 2 out of 5 from three-point range.
Council.
He turns.
Shoots it up. Dishes the 15. Oh.
Ingram. Flying high for
Ingram
the
rebound.
Cadeau gives it up. Ingram will pull a three.
Drains a three.
Harrison Ingram.
Ingram.
37% three-point shooter this year. Transferred from Stanford.
That's money in the bank. That's right,
year.
Brad.
Big-time rebounder. Top 10 of the nation in total rebounds. Here goes Council.
Council to the basket. Wide
in.
Open over there.
Off the dribble. Quick move.
66-50. Withers gets fouled going up.
What an incredible sequence on both ends by Melvin Council.
We'll watch the last two plays here.
Council with
ball,
a hustle
movement,
got back.
The skip pass. 2-on-1 on
all right,
the weak
Sean,
side.
See, buddy.
Money, and then here. Body
thank
blow,
you,
body blow, body blow. You know what I mean? Paint touch, paint touch, paint touch. Guess what? The trailer is wide open. People knock that in the transition offense.
Here we go, up in. Good, RJ Davis.
So Hubert Davis draws one up. RJ Davis lays it in.
18.
11 and a half for RJ Davis.
They got within
quiet first half, just 12 in the first half. He's got 16 overall.
And a turnover. And
another turnover. Davis with a steal up ahead.
Cadeau. Big slam. Withers.
Jalen Withers. A highlight for the Heels. You'll be seeing that one the rest of the night. A 10-2 run.
And the lead is 20, just like that.
Jalen Withers now with 16 points as Brown is fouled by Ryan. And let's give you another look.
That's something you practice on all the time. Fast break. 3-on-1.
Thanks for the subscribe.
Make the correct decision and play. And that time, Cadeau able to throw it right up to Jalen Withers. Showing that athleticism. But how quickly Carolina can respond to a run. Their own 10-2, like you said, spurred by their defense.
Got a chance at a double-double here, Jalen Withers. Having his best game of the year for Carolina. Here is Council. Missed it.
With a spin, misses. Ball still in the air.
For the rebound, and then lost the handle. Shot clock didn't reset.
So 0.3 on the shot clock.
So we'll take the timeout. Under 8. Reset the clock here.
Wagner coach
Donald Copeland grinding to try to find a way. His team down 20, though.
They were close, man. They got there. They were down 12. They were those draining threes, but then boom, boom, boom for Carolina, man. And that turnover, that's it. So lead is 20. The spread was 25. So we'll see what happens. Spread's 25. The over-under was 130. So we're close to that. We're close to that. So I went under on that. So I think that's definitely going to be the over. But thanks for all that love tonight. Make sure you're hitting that like button. What is that? Oh, that's another commercial. Make sure you're hitting that like button for us and subscribing to the channel. We're trying to get to 10,360 tonight. After this game is over, hit that like button as well. We're at 61 likes. Let's see if we can get 70 likes. 70 likes is that goal for us on that. But we're coming up at the Texas game. We'll be right after this game, about an hour or so after. Let's see, what time is it now? 3:26, so probably this won't be over till like 3:45 possibly. So an hour and a half, almost 2 hours will be a break. And then Texas versus Colorado State. Colorado State won on Tuesday night against Virginia. So we'll see what happens. Virginia just looked horrible. And then let's see, Morehead State and Illinois. Wow, tied at 39-38 Illinois. And then Oregon and South Carolina tied at 13 in the first. Another SEC team going at it. So hit that subscribe. Thank you so much for that subscribe as well. Appreciate that. Thank you for that subscribe. Taylor Campbell. Taylor, thank you for that subscribe too. Appreciate that. So let's see here what happens. And fun day. BYU went down. They're the only kind of upset that's happened so far today. Michigan State beat the Bulldogs. Mississippi State, the Battle of the States. They bought them down. So, cold beer. Get your cold beer. Get your cold beer. All right, here we go.
An undersized Wagner Seahawks getting dominated in the paint. Plus 18 is Carolina in the paint. Armando Bacot leading the way with 18 points. And chipping in with 14 rebounds as well. So very one-sided thus far. To be expected, Jim.
Yeah, but you stick to the script. And that's why game plans vary from game to game depending on who your opponent is. North Carolina wins this game. Their next opponent, Michigan State, it may be something a little bit different. They still want to dominate the paint. But the huge advantage is right here. So why go away from it when it's working?
They did reset the shot clock.
All right, Wagner ball down by 20.
Make contact with the rim. So a possession here for Wagner.
Shelton gives it right back. And Council drills a three-pointer.
Council with the three.
So impressed with what he's done.
I like Council.
I like him. His attack, his body, the way he's built, his athleticism. Not afraid to dirty
Council
it up
with
a little
17.
Bit. Get 2 feet in the paint. Athletic.
First team All-NEC performer. Been in a shooting slump before his game.
Davis with a three.
RJ Davis, pure stroke. Right
Davis
there.
Just
Davis
steps
had
up.
A big second half for the Tar Heels.
Well, it's because
nothing but net. 73-53. RJ Davis, 19
They're
points.
Contested, but not to the full extent because of the paint press.
Wagner
so now
trying
you're
again.
Able to get some cleaner, more efficient looks from beyond the arc, knowing that Wagner is more willing to kind of give those up.
Ends up in the hands of Council. Dumps it down to Lewis.
Lewis back out there. He shoots two. Good jumper for Lewis.
Keontae Lewis out of Chesterfield, Virginia. Just a sophomore.
Lead is 18.
Deflection. This Kara got another hand on that. Remember, he had three steals early.
Ooh, a turnover. Oh, almost a turnover.
It's going to be a backcourt violation.
Yeah.
Yep.
Unforced error by Wagner.
It's the sixth turnover by Wagner.
Wagner had to win three road games in the NEC
still,
tournament.
No, UNC has more turnovers, which is crazy.
Tournament.
C-Mac, when are UNC fans ever going to hold this
their first
head coach
NEC
accountable?
Title since 2003.
Are you saying that this
first
is not? This shouldn't be a. This should be a blowout. Is that what you're saying? That this shouldn't be this close? Baycock spins.
Baycock missed it.
Misses.
Keeps it alive into the
Council with
the
rebound. Here comes Council. Coast to coast dishes it out. Three.
Blocked by Ryan.
Blocked.
Weathers up ahead. Ingram runs.
Ingram.
Ingram scores.
Good. Back the other way.
Back up 20.
Brad Adams says RJ Davis is one bad dude.
I'm guessing Jalen Withers getting a shot of confidence here. Playing in the NCAA tournament.
Here
in his hometown here in Charlotte. Went to North Mecklenburg High School.
Council with the ball again.
He's had a great game.
Down by 20.
Eight boards for
Brown
Jalen
back
Withers.
To Council.
You can get that kind of production.
Back into Lewis. Withers. Lewis on Baycock.
You know, in the next game, it makes it extremely difficult.
Baycock on Lewis. Spin. Did he get it up? No.
Yeah, got a foul here.
We got a foul. Baycock fouled
got
him.
The foul right as the clock was expiring and saying that the foul came prior to the shot clock expiring.
And he's saying right there, that is a foul. So he got it on his left hand. But did the clock expire before the ball is out? So the foul occurred before.
Yeah.
So good call by the official. You know, the Carolina fans don't like it, but it was a great call.
You have no clue
Baycock
on what
really
we're talking about. He must be a Duke fan.
Kept those arms straight up and down.
Yes, Carolina would under Coach Smith would be up 40 right now. He played his match up and smoked them. No bench, then bench play.
Of the big dance and all the biggest moments in sports. Catch tournament highlights, picks, previews, recaps, and much more. Download the CBS Sports app.
Lewis
to watch today.
Gets it in.
One out of two.
Lead is 19.
Keontae Lewis gives him 13 points, four rebounds, been in foul trouble. He's playing with four fouls currently. Approaching the 5 minute mark. Carolina trying to put away the
wide open Ryan to the basket. Turns around, spins in and out.
Baycock
just manhandling. RJ Davis thought about a three.
This smart, and that's not a
4:55 to go.
Who is hunting for shots? You know, just patient. Like, I don't need to get it right now.
He's playing the game.
He's playing the game.
He had some sloppy turnovers, for sure, in this first half, which kind of cost it to be that close. Wagner didn't turn the ball over, though. They didn't let them make mistakes. Council spin on Withers. Withers rebound.
He was going in attack mode. He said, I gave it up to you once.
What a pass. Cormac Ryan on the receiving end from R.J. Davis.
Ryan.
Good look inside. Carolina poised for a matchup with Michigan State. Michigan State as a 9 seed took down Mississippi State, the 8 seed, in the first game.
And shot Michigan State, Carolina, that's going to be a matchup.
Beyond three, you know, Mississippi State
missed the three shot. Here comes Carolina, R.J. Davis, 3.
R.J. Davis.
Davis, 3.
The finishing touches here. Huge second half. He's got 22
now. Hit the like
now.
Button if you like Carolina. You like Carolina, subscribe.
Number 2, Davis buries his 4th three-pointer. Boy, it's set up for a great matchup, though. Blue Bloods in college basketball, Carolina and Michigan State. The defensive-minded Spartans. Tom Izzo always.
Baycock again. Now they're finally Baycock pulling away. 82-56.
All those matchups with Roy Baycock. Williams. And now it's going to be Hubert Davis and Tom Izzo.
With 20 points.
And we are set up for a dandy on Saturday. For the right to go to Los Angeles in the Sweet 16. UNC, the top seed. They are rolling now with 3 and change remaining in round 1.
All right. So thank you so much, guys, for the subscribes. Appreciate all the love. Got their 10,360. And 82-56. Carolina finally pulling away. Like I said, money in the bank, baby. All right. So let's see. I'm going to put the other game coming up later on in the chat here. So let me do that real quick. So Texas, Colorado State. Let me share that one here. Copy. Put that link. Next stream. Texas versus Colorado State. Where's Texas? There's Texas. Where's Colorado State? There's that. Okay. Just waiting on the stream to come back, y'all. Stay with me. Paste. There's that one. So just put the link in the chat for tonight's game coming up around 5:55 or maybe earlier. That is the next stream, Texas versus Colorado State. Make sure you go there and hit that like button for us and subscribe or hit the notification bells so you know when we go live the next time. Oregon, South Carolina, good game. And Morehead, Illinois, yeah. So Morehead State's up. Down by 1, and Oregon is down by 1 to South Carolina. So both games, Morehead State and Illinois at half. Man, wouldn't that be some Morehead State knocks off Illinois? Looks like the Heels are going to cover the 25. Yep. Yep. They're like, hey, just by the way, just by chance, you guys, our spread is 25. You might want to do something about that. So that Pizza Hut looks pretty good. I might have to get that tonight. Taylor says, a big UNC Tar Heel failure. Awesome, Taylor. Good to see you here. Appreciate it. Thanks for hanging out with us. We did almost had 200, over 200 in here just a little while ago. One more like to 70. Hit that like button. We'll see if we can get to 100 likes. 183 of us here. I'm sure someone hasn't hit the like button yet. Let's see if we can get to 100 likes for us on this. If you're a Tar Heel fan, hit the like button.
Here, Wagner trailed by 18. Cut it to 12. All UNC sense. By the way, Jimmy, there's Domenska. Estime, 28-year-old head athletic trainer at Wagner, came from Haiti to Brooklyn. She was a two-sport athlete, had a bunch of injuries.
Wagner drains it, too.
Mascara knocks it down. She decided, because they got her right, she wanted to be an athletic trainer. And here she is in the NCAA tournament. I said, your parents must be so proud. She goes, oh, they just think I'm going to work.
Exactly. They don't know what I do.
For a living. But anyway...
UNC turned it over.
You made us all proud.
Yep. Now, she had a great story, too, talking about her athletic background. And
Tom Izzo knows how to play North Carolina.
Been given here Wagner. I mean, there's always those little intricate
stories. If
they can
stop Baycock,
you find out a lot more about
when you're covering a team
that you normally don't cover during the course of the year.
Worked as an intern in the WNBA. She worked for the Aces.
Liberty.
Living out a dream. She's already finding her path in this business. And, yep. We wish her luck. only 28 years of age. She's got such a great future. We really enjoyed talking to her yesterday. Domenska Estime.
Well, speaking 2:45 to go here, y'all.
I know this is a disappointing loss for Wagner, but the core group in which the players are on the
court drains it. Sophomores
for Wagner. All this experience Trumbull of going through with the conference three. Tournament, winning it, being here in the tournament,
58 Wagner trying to make this respectable,
along with some fresh bodies. This Wagner team is lead is to do 27 some next year. A lot of talent returning.
Taron Allen playing in foul trouble. Zayden High on the floor. Woja got some early playing time in this game tonight. Be matching up against his father at Michigan State. In the second round coming up Saturday, Paxson Wojcik, his dad Doug, an assistant at Michigan State.
27. That's what I was right the first time.
Final
27.
2 minutes here. Been a great
the spread
run
was
for
25.
Wagner. Incredible run. And enrollment just over 2,100. Think about the discrepancy.
At least they're cheering on Wagner still.
In the enrollment at each of these schools.
UNC Staten rebound. Island, 1:40 to go here.
Their first ever NCAA tournament victory at the first four.
And a foul.
Holding off Howard on Tuesday
Wagner.
Night.
Washington will shoot.
The NEC tournament champs. Their former coach, Bashir Mason, he'll have St. Peter's matching up against Tennessee. I know Donald Copeland is disappointed, but he is proving quickly that he is going to be a formidable head
coach. We need
the
over.
At the collegiate level. He's in his second year. Talented point guard at Seton Hall. He was an assistant under Kevin Willard at Seton Hall. He is Jersey through and
through. I thought the over was 130, right?
He's got a bright future ahead of him as well.
Yeah, well, you know, the fight was there, but then sometimes the realization that you run out of talent.
I thought the over was 130.
Sometimes sets in, and that's what happened with Wagner.
143 has been scored. Yeah.
Was there all afternoon.
I thought the over is over.
That's what you look at and you judge your team on. Yeah, we were outmanned.
All benching here for
but
NC.
The heart and the effort was still there.
Shoot a three.
All the way down to the buzzer.
It's the three from NBA line.
Making these shots. You never saw
backup guys draining threes. Who was that?
Hang their heads. They continue to compete, and that's a reflection, you know, on their parents, but also this coaching staff.
Wojcik reins in that three-pointer. He came in that first half for defensive purposes. Great Lieber on the floor as well, trying to guard Council.
Wagner trying to throw it up.
Zayden High up
Wojcik
high for the block.
Wojcik with the three.
Freshman out of Rockwell, Texas.
Woj.
Dwayne Ferris. Dewey Ferris, I should
so
say.
GG Wagner.
And the end of the line for Wojcik and Jalen Washington. Rob Landry getting a minute of play in the NCAA tournament as well. These guys put in the hard work. Scout team put in the grind, getting minutes here in March Madness.
Three for Wagner drains it.
Three-pointer finally goes down for Javier Esquerra.
Esquerra with a three.
He's been impressive to watch as well. The point guard.
27. The spread's 25.
Put out Bleacher Report, the point gods of Puerto Rico, J.J. Barea, Carlos Arroyo.
And good.
On the board. Rob Landry scores it, much to the delight
Landry
of
the
Carolina
with the
bench.
Two. 90-61. The Tar Heels putting up 90 points here in this first
obviously
round.
Looking up to those guys, Jose Alvarado and J.J. Barea and Carlos Arroyo. Great moment for him from Puerto Rico to be in the NCAA tournament as well. Michigan State and North Carolina set for a second round matchup as
and Council gets fouled going to the basket.
Well, this is going to be some battle Saturday. Hubert Davis and Tom Izzo very much looking forward to this one, Jimmy.
You know, it's the same thing. The size of North Carolina inside protecting the paint. The transition offense for Tom Izzo. Can they get those easier baskets in their secondary breaks against this North Carolina team and protect the paint? You know, that's the and you're able to do that when you're able to knock in shots from the perimeter. I think you'll see a lot more aggressive R.J. Davis from the beginning because of the guard matchup from Michigan State.
G.G. Wagner,
man, you're talking
UNC
about
Tar Heels, move on.
On Saturday.
Thank you guys for all the likes and subs today.
Appreciate
you guys.
Call that one.
It's going to be something special. Hubert Davis the ACC Coach of the Year, takes out the 16-2
record in the round of 64.
Armando Bacot with a monster game. 20 points, 15 rebounds, his sixth consecutive NCAA tournament game with 15 boards. Jalen Withers was outstanding as well in his hometown. So the stage is all set. Blue Bloods in college basketball.
Aiming to hit that like.
From Charlotte,
thank you, man.
North Carolina.
Watch
it
a couple commercials.
A pro Carolina Tar Heel crowd. They sold out this one. You know it'll be a sellout on Saturday. The top seed Tar Heels take it on.
Check
Michigan
out
State.
We're doing the Kentucky game
Mississippi
tonight
State
at 5, I think.
Earlier today. Let's send it over to Allie LaForce with Armando Bacot. Take it away.
Armando, congratulations. You told me yesterday that being a one seed comes with a great level of responsibility. How would you describe the sense of urgency this UNC team has?
I thought overall for the game we played good. We made a lot of mistakes, especially early on, just trying to get back into playing since the tough game on Saturday. But overall, we're happy with it, and we're ready to go to the drawing board. We know we got a tough Michigan State coming up, and we got to be ready.
You shot a high percentage from three that game as a team. You scored in the paint. It was a great, well-rounded offensive effort. What goes into continuing that on even as the opponent gets tougher?
Really just doing what we've been doing all year, setting great screens, and just trusting and believing in the teammate. And I think that's what's got us this far, so why not stop now?
See you on Saturday. Thanks, Armando.
Appreciate it.
Armando Bacot, year number 5. This West Regional has UNC and Arizona, Baylor, Alabama, but it's Michigan State coming up next. Tournament games continue live now on True TV, TNT, and TBS. CBS primetime begins at 7 Eastern, Oakland and Kentucky. Right now, we'll send you to our studio after these messages as the top-seeded Tar Heels, they roll in Charlotte.
All right, so there it is. 90-62 is the score. And now let's see here. This. Let's take a look at the stats really quick of this game. Wagner wouldn't go away, y'all. They would not go away. They kept on draining those threes. Well coached, yeah. He wasn't happy, though. He was not a happy camper about what went down. Was not a happy camper. Yeah. Let's take a look at the team stats here. Let me bring this up. All right. So, field goal percentage, 23 for 58 for Wagner, 33 for 60 for North Carolina, 55% from the field, that's pretty good, and 50% from the three-point line. That's victory formation right there for you guys. So, three-point line, 9 for 18, half of them, drilling them. RJ Davis, Ryan, all those guys just nailed them. 15 for 19 from the free throw line. 9 for 15 for Wagner, 60%. 43 rebounds for UNC. Bacot doing its thing. 24 for Wagner. Assist, 14 for UNC, 8 for Wagner. 4 steals for UNC, only 5 for Wagner. They win the category there. 3 blocks for UNC, 2 for Wagner. Total turnovers, 8 for UNC, or 9 for UNC, 8 for Wagner. Total points off of that, 11 points for the turnovers for Wagner. So maybe those points in the paint there. Points in the paint, just ridiculous. Bacot, Weathers, all those guys down front. Tough. Davis going to the basket. All those guys, 48 points in the paint to 20 for Wagner. Just too big, too strong. So 13 fouls each. The lead, the largest lead was 30 points for the Tar Heels. They win by 32. And they definitely clear the line. So the over-under is cleared as well. They go over on this game. And let's see here. We go to the box score real quick. For Wagner, top scorer was, two top scorers. Council at 18. He was 6 for 20. Broom was 6 for 10. He had 18 points as well. 13 for Lewis. So Lewis, he fouled. He had 4 fouls. And also, Allen had 4 as well. But there is that. Most rebounds was Lewis and Council. North Carolina Tar Heels here, 20 points for Baycock, 22 for Davis, 13 for Ryan. Double-double for Baycock, 15 rebounds, 20 points. Easy day at the office. There's another double-double. Withers, 10 rebounds, 16 points. So two guys with double-doubles, and that is it. So let's take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard really quick. As Morehead State up by one on Illinois, would that be a shocker if that goes down like that? Let me see if I can pull this up. So there we go. Oregon and South Carolina, 29-22. Wright's got 5 points. Nevada, Dayton. Dayton just tipped off 5-0 against Nevada. Colorado State, Texas, that's our game coming up at 5:50. So make sure you're there for us for that. Oakland, Kentucky as well at 6:10. McNeese and Gonzaga. I can't wait to watch this game or on the stats while we do the game. South Dakota, Iowa State. And then our another game, St. Peter's at Tennessee. UNC and Texas Tech. Stanford at Kansas. That should be interesting. Drake at Washington State. And then our finals, Arizona beats Long Beach State. They're done. Creighton beats Akron. BYU goes down to McKinsey. And Michigan State takes down Mississippi State. So there is all of those. And that's it. Appreciate y'all hanging out here today. Thanks for the likes. Do you think UNC can win it all if they play sloppy like that? No. But we'll see what happens. So appreciate all the love. 75 likes. All the subscribers, thank you so much. We'll see you here in a little bit, in about an hour and 2 hours or whatever it is. Go from there. A little break for CeeLo. And I want to thank my wife, my lovely wife, Spain. I love you for everything you do for me. And us, and the whole family. I want to thank my mods for always being here and hanging out, even if they don't like the sport. I want to thank my members for giving your hard-earned money back to the channel. We appreciate you as well. And I want to thank you guys for watching. And until then, we will see all the new subscribers. Thank you guys, and hope to see you guys back tonight. Until then, we'll see you later. Let's give the Vols a victory tonight. Congratulations, UNC North Carolina, on the big win. If you're watching on a replay, make sure you're hitting that like button as well and subscribing to the channel for all your NCAA basketball tournament content. We'll see you guys later in about 2 hours. See ya.